So I've got another prime number generating formula for you. So this one is more modern. It was 1947, a mathematician called Mills, and he found this formula. He said there exist numbers, which we're going to call theta, the Greek letter theta, where you raise it to the power 3 to the power n, and you actually then have to round it down. That gives you fractions. So you actually round it down to the nearest whole number, which you write like this. That's the symbol for rounding it down. He says there exists a number like this that will always give you primes for every value of n. So you might have n equals 1, n equals 2, n equals 3, and every value is a prime. The smallest value for theta where this will work, it's called Mill's constant. I'll write it out for you. So it's called theta, and Mill's constant is 1.3063788638630806900 something. So it's you can see it's not a whole number. So the value you get when you raise it is going to be, it's not going to be a whole number, and you have to round it down. Let me just try the first few to show you what I mean. Let's do n equals 1. Let's use my constant. You put it in, so then it's 3 to the power 1, so it's just cubed. So what I'm going to do is for each time, I'm going to take this constant and then raise it to the power 3 to the power n, and I'll do that for n equals 1, n equals 2, and so on. So n equals 1, 3 to the power n is just 3, so that's going to be theta cubed. That's the first prime. And what is the answer? What is theta cubed? Theta cubed is 2.229 something, something, something. You round it down, so the prime is 2. Hey, we've got, that is prime. And in fact, every number should be prime. Let's try the next one. Let's do n equals 2. So this is going to be 3 squared. It's theta to the power 9. So take the constant to the power 9. And that is going to be 11.082 something something. Round it down, you get 11. So you get gaps. It's not consecutive primes, but everyone is a prime. You get 11. That's the next one. Let's do n equals 3. So I now need theta 3 to the power 3, 27. Theta to the power 27 is 1,361.000 something something something. 1,361 is a prime as well. Let's do n equals 4, theta to the power 81. Yeah, 252,100,887.
Oh yeah, that's clearly a prime.
Which is a prime. Point something, 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 but you round it down. But you actually guarantee to get a prime every time.
Do you know what my conclusion is? Hmm. That number's awesome.
I know. I completely agree. That number is completely awesome. So the rock stars of maths are pi and e and these golden ratios and things like that. It's not nearly as famous. It's a constant that gives you primes. Brilliant. I love it.
Is it proven that, I mean, there's a lot of n's you could put into that equation. Is this a proven thing?
Yeah, this is proven. This is proven. So you might think then, well, what's the big deal? We've got a formula to find guaranteed primes. How amazing is that? And the problem is, did you notice how big the powers were getting? The powers very quickly become so huge that even computers can't deal with the problem. So the next one, n equals 5, is theta to the power 243. And this is about 1.602 times 10 to the 28. Once you start getting bigger than that, you can't do it. The computers can't cope with that. The other problem is, you need to know this constant to a great accuracy, because what I've written out for you, let's say if I terminated it there, isn't accurate enough to tell me what the next prime is. The next prime actually is something huge. We'll put that on the screen, I think, instead of writing it out. But this was not accurate enough. to work it out. That's a bit of a problem. You need to know theta very, very accurately.
Is theta rational? Does theta have an
end? We don't know. We don't know. How amazing is that? We don't know if theta is irrational or not. That's a cool question as well. We don't know. There is one of the other problems with theta is at the moment, we don't know any way to really work it out apart from taking one of the mil primes. You take one of the mil primes, cube root it, and theta is approximately that. So I'm afraid it's a bit of a circular argument. We haven't got a good way of working out theta. You have to know the primes in the first place to work out theta.
Oh, well, I'm not so impressed by it anymore.
I know, so you can see why it's not so practical. One of the things that we might be able to do is if Riemann's hypothesis is true. Riemann's hypothesis is a very important hypothesis in mathematics that hasn't been proven yet. That is a Millennium Prize, and it's related to primes and how they're distributed. If that is true, probably is true. If it's true, then we have another way to find mil primes. Using that method, we can now calculate what theta is probably going to be. It's been calculated up to about 7,000 digits, but it is relying on if the Riemann hypothesis is true, which hasn't been proven, it's probably true. We have worked out larger mil primes, and we have worked out theta to a large number of places.
Our thanks to audible.com for supporting this video. They have a huge range of audiobooks you can listen to, great for putting on your handheld device or listening to in the car, and you can download a free book at audible.com/numberphile. This is the part where we get to recommend a book, which I always enjoy, and today I'd like to recommend Foundation by Isaac Asimov, the first in a brilliant series of books, probably my favourite series of books ever. So go to audible.com/numberphile, get a free book, and why not check out, well, anything by Isaac Asimov, but especially Foundation or any of its sequels and prequels.